traffic in this Washington State interchange flows like clockwork thanks to three unique roundabouts. It wasn't always this safe and efficient. The intersection of Slater Road and Interstate 5 had increasing problems with traffic backup.
Level of service was F, they were failing. We had people backing up on Main Line. They were going 70 on the interstate. They didn't know what to do. Whatcom County had to do something.
A team of transportation professionals used a novel approach called data-driven safety analysis to solve the complicated traffic problem and justify their decisions. Data-driven safety analysis is the application of the latest generation of tools for analyzing crash and roadway data. These tools quantify safety impacts so agencies can make more informed decisions, better target their investments, and reduce severe crashes on the roadways. The team analyzed each intersection and decided that a series of compact roundabouts would provide the best level of service and benefit cost.
The highway safety manual applications gave us the encouragement to show that we wouldn't compromise safety and still gain the amazing safety benefits that roundabouts afford. So we suggested let's put a compact in the existing right-of-way.
For the project to work within budget constraints, the team had to take a flexible approach to the design.
So we started doing things like taking out the outside curbing. Drainage was easier and less expensive. And then we started playing with the size of the roundabout.
A speed study confirmed that the vehicle speeds at the compact roundabouts were similar to larger modern roundabouts at a fraction of the cost.
It would cost $1 million to $2 million at each intersection to do something like that, and there was just no funding available for that type of solution at the time. These were about $100,000 per intersection, so a fraction of the overall cost.
Some didn't think the roundabouts would adequately accommodate all vehicles, especially large trucks.
But we recognized here that we needed to get the trucks through and we weren't going with as big a roundabout as traditional. And so with that in mind, and to save costs, we went with a flat center so that trucks could traverse more easily through the roundabout.
But we showed with the data that, trust us, the motorists do react just like they have shown in the past, and that was the biggest convincing factors for the stakeholders in the Slater Road roundabouts.
The analysis enabled the team to customize the project to the safety needs and budget of their location.
That way you don't build a project that's unnecessary for what's happening at that location. You can really hone in on what is the issue and focus on that as a part of the safety piece of that project.
But it really takes thinking out of the box, using the tools that are available at hand, tweaking designs, and seeing that sweet spot where you're optimizing your existing location, your existing roadway prism, but maximizing the safety.
The compact roundabouts alleviated the traffic problem, fit into the existing budget, and provided a safer roadway for travelers.
We don't see those backups on the interstate anymore down the ramp onto the interstate. The county road behind me is functioning just wonderfully.
And now we have level service B and the safety benefits of a roundabout. We almost can't sleep at night now that we know we can put in roundabouts for 100,000 in a weekend. We almost can't not do something because we have proof now.